Government agencies use a variety of chemicals to aid in the suppression of fire in wildlands. But who decides how and what chemicals may be used? How are they mixed? And which chemicals might cause harm to humans or animals? All federal and most state land management agencies have a policy which states that all wildland fire chemicals must be evaluated and approved prior to use. Once they are, they become part of the qualified products list. How does the process work? Let's start at the beginning. First, performance requirements are established with input from firefighters in the field. The proposed chemicals must meet certain performance criteria for effectiveness, safety, environmental protection, materials protection, and stability. Testing can take a year and a half to 2 years and is paid for by the fire chemical manufacturer. Let's look at the performance criteria in more detail. When considering retarding or suppressing effectiveness, the chemicals must prove to be effective at slowing down or putting out a fire, or slowing down or preventing ignition. The test chemical used as the baseline standard for long-term retardant is diammonium phosphate, a type of fertilizer. Any new retardant tested must be at least as effective as a 10.6% diammonium phosphate concentration in combustion retarding tests. To promote safety, new products are tested to meet human health requirements, including acute or short-term oral toxicity, acute skin toxicity, and eye and skin irritation. Will the chemicals harm aquatic wildlife? Acute toxicity testing measures a 96-hour exposure of chemicals to juvenile rainbow trout. Further, are the chemicals biodegradable? That is, can they decompose as a result of bacterial action? If they want to make the qualified products list, foams must be biodegradable. Do the chemicals cause metal corrosion? Too much, and they won't make the list. Will the chemicals hold up over time? Since chemical products may be stored outside for a period of 12 months, the chemicals must have the ability to maintain their effectiveness over this time period. Last, a judgment is made by field testers regarding the ease of mixing and handling of the chemicals. Only when all of these criteria are met can a fire chemical be listed on the qualified products list. And only chemicals on the list can be purchased by U.S. federal and most state wildland management agencies, including the U.S. Forest Service. The qualified products list is also recognized by many other firefighting agencies around the world. You'll find the current list on the Wildland Fire Chemical Systems website. The USDA and U.S. Forest Service have produced a series of videos that discuss wildland fire chemicals in more depth. We hope you'll view each one to learn more about these important topics. In addition to finding the qualified products list, you'll also find a plethora of useful information on such issues as safety, environmental issues, product quality, mixing ratios, aerial delivery systems, and other topics related to knowing when and how to use wildland fire chemicals.